Welcome back. Natasha Palha did not have a Goan tennis player to seek inspiration from while she was learning to play tennis more than a decade ago. However, the Goan youngsters now do have a tennis star to follow in the form of the India number 3. Dilip Sardesai Sports Excellence Awardee Natasha Palha wants to become the number 1 player in India in the new year.
For the few school students present on the day, 20-year-old Natasha Palha received the Dilip Sardesai Sports Excellence Award. It was an inspiring moment to see one of their fellow Goan had made a professional career in Indian tennis. Natasha, inspired by her parents to take to tennis, did not have a role model to follow when she was in school. Feeling good about the years and years of hard work, Natasha is happy that she has put Goa on the elite tennis scenario.
It's amazing, especially coming from Goa, to be good in tennis, because there are around 300 girls playing tennis and just one from Goa. So I'm really thankful to everyone who has helped me to be right up in the top 3 in India.
This year we have seen two new tennis leagues starting. One is the Champions Tennis League and the other is the International Premier Tennis League. So what will be your target now for the next season? Which league would you like to play in?
I think one step at a time. First, I would love to play in the Champions Tennis League, and then the ITPL, the international one. That would be an amazing feat, because to be in that, I would have to be in the top 10 in the world, and I would have no words if I was going to be playing that league.
The new year is approaching, so what is your target for the new year?
I'm going to try to be number 1 in India and 350 in the world rankings.
And with regards to the Grand Slams, when can we see you playing in a Grand Slam?
Maybe at the age of 23, 24 hopefully.
Sports editor Neeraj Prabhu with senior video journalist Toshidas Chari for Prudent.
The BCCI Senior Women's One Day Cricket League kicked off at 3 different venues in Goa on Saturday. Host Goa lost their opener to Rajasthan in a low-scoring contest at Porvorim. Tamil Nadu defeated Gujarat by 101 runs in Madgaon, while Kerala thrashed Jammu and Kashmir by 101 runs in Panaji.
Goa struggled to put up decent partnerships after electing to bat first and could post a total of 114 all-out in 49.4 overs. Experienced all-rounder Santoshi Rane played a crucial knock of 59 runs and contributed more than half of Goa's total. No other Goan batter got into double digits, which tells the story of a good bowling performance by Rajasthan. In reply, the visitors did not find it easy either, with Goan bowlers giving it their all. Rajasthan had to work hard for every run, but reached the target for the loss of 7 wickets in the 49th over. Over at Panaji Gymkhana ground, Kerala won the toss and batted first. They scored 164 runs for 9 wickets in their allotted 50 overs. In reply, Jammu and Kashmir were shot out for just 63 runs in 36.3 overs. Meanwhile, at MCC ground in Madgaon, Tamil Nadu defeated Gujarat in another one-sided match. Batting first, Tamil Nadu scored 203 for 7 in their 50 overs. Gujarat were all out for 102 runs in the 47th over. Bureau Report, Prudent.
And with this, we come to an end of this news bulletin. Keep watching Prudent.
Tumi porita Prudent. You're watching Prudent.